Hello, this is Eric D. Kirk from MamaWorld.com. In this part of our tutorial series, we'll start with something very basic and create the following text overlay. And if you are using Premiere Pro and want to start learning how to create titles or lower thirds for your projects in After Effects, then this is exactly the right tutorial for you. We start here in Premiere Pro, and in the timeline, we right-click on the clip that we want to manipulate in After Effects and choose Replace with After Effects Composition. Now After Effects starts automatically and creates a project for this clip. All I need to do is choose where the project should be saved. The user interface of After Effects might look a bit overwhelming at first, but it's very similar to Premiere Pro. You have your project panel with all of your footage and all of your sequences, which are actually called compositions in After Effects. As you can see, your clip has already been imported here. Also, a composition has already been created that contains exactly the part of the clip that we had in our Premiere Pro sequence. If you already have an After Effects project open when creating an After Effects composition in Premiere Pro, Premiere will not create a new project, but will simply add to the currently open one instead. So let's say we select the first clip here in the Premiere Pro timeline and again right-click and choose Replace with After Effects Composition. Now a new footage item and a new composition have been added to the same After Effects project. If we double-click on one of the compositions in the project panel, it is opened here in the viewer and here in the timeline. You can also switch between the open compositions by clicking on the different tabs here in the timeline. To give a composition a more meaningful name, just select it in the project panel and hit the Enter key on your keyboard. Let's call this one Scene 1 and this one Scene 2. Now let's create our text. We choose the Text tool and click in the preview monitor where the text should be and type Featuring. As you can see, we now have a layer for our text here in the timeline. Let's click with the Text tool again in the viewer and create a second layer, John Doe. Now we are done with the Text tool and go back to the Normal Selection tool. Then we go to the Window Character to reveal the Character panel where we can choose the font, size, and color for the text. Once we're happy with the design, we can start animating. For this, we will use Effects and the extension Squash and Stretch for After Effects, which contains lots of ready-to-use animations that you can apply in a single click. Let's start with the fun part and use Squash and Stretch. It is available both in a free version and a pro version. Let's take a look at the free version first. We click on this icon here to open the behavior browser of Squash and Stretch. Here you can see all the behaviors that are included in the free version. Let's pick this throw behavior, for example. We simply select the layer here, move the current time indicator to the time where the behavior should end, because this should be the end position of the animation, and the timing option here is set to end of behavior, and then apply the behavior. Now we confirm here that the text should be split into individual characters because it usually looks much better if each character is animated individually. We also confirm this message, which reminds us that Squash and Stretch will need to pre-compose the text to make the animation work. You see with the Squash and Stretch extension that it's pretty easy to create complex animations, but this animation is not really what we want, so let's quickly undo it again. We'll look for a more subtle animation, of which you find plenty in the broadcast bundle of Squash and Stretch Pro. Squash and Stretch Pro contains 60 behaviors and can be extended with extra bundles that can be purchased separately. The broadcast bundle is one of those and contains 130 additional behaviors, so a lot of animations to choose from. We want to use the scale in middle abrupt to slow. Again, before we apply the behavior, we need to move to the point in time where the animation should end. For this, it is very handy to know how long the animation actually is. We can simply click this work area button here, which will set the work area in the timeline exactly to the duration of the behavior. Now we know that if the behavior should start at the beginning of the composition, it will end exactly here. Now we select both layers since we want to apply the behavior to both of them, and then click Apply. This time we decided to not split the text, since it should animate as one single object and not each letter separately. Now let's refine the animation with an additional effect. We select both layers and go to Effect, Blur, and Sharpen Gaussian Blur. If we twirl down the details of the two layers by clicking on this triangle, in the section Effects, you can now see the Gaussian Blur that we just applied. You can also see the Squash and Stretch Bezier Warp effect that Squash and Stretch created when we applied the behavior. In general, Squash and Stretch creates effects and keyframes on your layers to create its animations, but you don't need to bother about the details. If you reveal the details of the blur effect, you can control the blurriness by clicking and dragging this number here. We want the text to start with a heavy blur that should disappear over time. To change the blurriness over time, we need to keyframe it. We first make sure that we are at the frame where the animation should start, say this frame here, which is the first frame where the text is clearly visible. Then we click this stopwatch here, which activates keyframing for the property. If we now change the blurriness again, it will only change the blurriness for the keyframe at the current position and not for the entire duration of the composition. Let's set the blur to about 100 so that the text is barely visible. Then we move to the end of the animation and set the blurriness to 0. As you can see, that created a second keyframe, and the blurriness now fades out nicely. Finally, we'll work a little bit on the timing. We don't want the text to appear immediately at the beginning, so we just drag them a bit to the right. As you can see, all the keyframes move with the layers automatically. Also, maybe we'll make the featuring text appear a tiny little bit before the John Doe text, so we'll make sure just this single text is selected and move it a bit to the side. Once we are happy with our result, we'll make sure to save it and go back to Premiere Pro. As you can see, due to Dynamic Link, everything we did in After Effects is now directly available inside of Premiere Pro. I hope this tutorial helps you get started with After Effects. In the next part of this series, we'll create a lower third, and you will learn how to work with shape layers. For a more comprehensive introduction to After Effects, please also check out our Mama World Guru lessons. If you can't wait to see new tutorials from us, please subscribe to our newsletter at mamaworld.com/subscribe. In the newsletter, we share our new tutorials before they are released on the website. So this is the way to go if you want to see all free tutorials before everybody else. Again, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamaworld.com, and we'll see you next time.